Welcome to Mr. G's Art. We just finished watching a video about Van Gogh and learned about his Starry Night and his sunflowers. So today we're going to combine the two. So first we will draw our sunflowers. I will send you examples of how to draw a sunflower, but it's up to you how you and where you will position your sunflower. One, I'll have one coming off the paper that is really close. We're going to draw a nice half circle in the corner. Then we will draw our sunflower petals, just like little rainbow lines. You can make yours really pointy, or you can always change it up, make them rounder. It's up to you. If you come off your paper, it makes it a little bit more interesting. Then next, I could draw a sunflower. Is right here. I'll draw a half oval, so it's kind of facing to the right, so we're not seeing it completely to the front. Then we draw our petals, like little rainbow lines. You always draw your smaller and not as wider lines. You always change it up. Then on the bottom, I'm going to draw them overlapping, kind of facing the direction over to the right. And draw one more connecting. Then we're going to draw a nice little round, connect them, and notice we drew over this line, so we're going to go back and erase. And next, we will draw a stem of a flower. Still cute, make it more interesting if you make it like a nice curl or a curve, not just straight down. Makes it a little bit more interesting. You can always go back and add leaves to yours. You do not have to add leaves. Mine's just a quick example of how to do it. Then the back of them has a green part back of the flower. Then I will draw another little sunflower connecting. But you don't have to do this one. You can make this one totally separate. And for the back of the flower, has a little green stuff behind it. And this one is totally to the side. This one, you kind of see it. Now this one's totally facing right, so you can't see it at all. So we just only see the flower petal. So you could keep only face all the way to the right. If you're good at adding more sunflowers, that's okay. Now we're gonna work on our background. We're gonna add the, remember the starry night. We're gonna add the moon. So your moon could be any place. You put it on the right side or the left side. I'm gonna put mine to the right. Nice crescent moon. Just start with the letter C. Then we go inside and go narrow to wide to narrow. Then just add little circles to be the little stars. It's up to you how many stars you want. Then we go back and add some color to it. So grab my marker. You do this with markers, color pencils, or crayons. I will color my flower petal yellow. Just remember, if you use a marker, do not keep coloring the exact same spot over and over again. If you do, make your paper weaker and it will rip your paper. Maybe use a nice one swipe or maybe two swipes of the marker to make it colored. No more than that. Then we come to the middle example. You can either color it brown or gold. There's lots of different ways. I'll color mine brown. And remember how you color it, if you color in the same direction, will make it look a lot nicer. Then we'll start adding texture to our flower. And take a like a yellow orange, or if you want a little bit darker, if you use red orange or red orange. We're gonna draw some lines on our flower to create some grooves. If you've seen a flower close up, not completely smooth, it has little ridges and bumps. If you want to add more, you can. Then, in the middle, we will add our lines for our sunflower seeds. You know, sunflower seeds come from these flowers. We will draw our lines, nice, quick little dashed lines. We take a black or a dark brown to color it. Just little lines. Use color pencils, markers. Create some nice texture for our sunflower. Blend across more than one art material mix and mix media. I use more than one different art mediums. So you will do the exact same thing for this one too. Then once we have both of these colors, then we will work on our background. Remember Van Gogh used short dashed lines to create his art. So you could use that for his. So we're going to use a start with the moon, so it'd be nice bright yellow. Or if you have a gold color, you could use gold instead. So color the color of the moon. Then color the stars. Then now we're going to kind of help it keep it glowing. We'll draw nice swirl lines around because like they're shiny. Same with the moon. Nice dash lines around it. Doesn't have to be exactly even. And kind of gives it like a glowing effect at night. Then next, we'll do his background. So we'll do shades of blues and purples. And we're also going to create nice dash lines. And we're just going to overlap them. And go further back. We're going to keep doing this, building up our layers. It's okay to have some white. You can always keep going back and forth. Just know that colors you have to use in order. Just pick any color you want to start with. Just kind of overlap the previous one. Make sure you avoid the sunflowers. It's okay when they start touching, that's okay. Just, if you want to make it dark to light, you can. And I'm going to use some purple too. You want to add more blue, you can go back and add more blue to it. You can keep doing this and working on it all around. And then it turns out something like this. If you want to, you can always make a nice swirl pattern. You keep building up your layers. You always, if you don't want to use purple, you don't have to use purple, but you can always just build up with different shades of blues and lines. And create your Van Gogh Starry Night.